Hi folks, welcome to episode 60 of I Don't Want to Hold Your Hand, the Beatles Quarantine Catalog, where I am attempting to play all 248 Beatles songs in chronological order while I am still stuck inside. As always, I'm on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, and Venmo in case you'd like to subscribe, follow, share, or support the series. Let's talk about the Beatles. Between January 29th and March 1st of 1964, the Beatles recorded 9 songs for their upcoming feature film, A Hard Day's Night. On March 2nd, with literally no time off, the Beatles began shooting the film itself. Of those 9 songs, only 7 would actually appear in the movie, and therefore the soundtrack, relegating 2 of them to be released as singles. Beatles song number 60 is one of those tunes. Of course, I'm talking about the Beatles' legendary cover of Little Richard's legendary single, Long Tall Sally. Born in Georgia in 1932 as Richard Pennyman, Little Richard was one of the architects of rock and roll. In fact, that's one of his many, many nicknames. Little Richard began his career recording music on various labels with a little success until 1955 when he recorded Tutti Frutti, which hit number 17 on the pop charts. However, soon after the song released, crooner Pat Boone did a cover of Tutti Frutti, which hit number 12 on the pop charts. Not great for Richard. In response to this, Little Richard and his producer Robert Bumps Blackwell decided to write a song so fast that Pat Boone couldn't even sing it. And combine that with this lyric written by a little girl, Long Tall Sally was born. And although Pat Boone would record a version anyway, his version would only hit number 8 on the pop charts, and Little Richard's Long Tall Sally would reach number 6. Little Richard would go on to become an absolute legend in rock and roll. There's no doubt that he is on the Mount Rushmore of rock and roll. And Long Tall Sally is possibly one of the most important songs that John, Paul, George, and Ringo would ever hear. In fact, Long Tall Sally is arguably the first song to be a staple in the set list of the Quarrymen, the group that famously became the Beatles. And fast forward to August 29th of 1966 at Candlestick Park in San Francisco, Long Tall Sally was the last song the Beatles ever performed in a Beatles concert. This makes Long Tall Sally the most enduring Beatles song in the entire catalog. In fact, you could argue it was their most performed song when it was all said and done. Things to listen for in this tune, Long Tall Sally is in that rare group of Beatles songs that was recorded in one take. They played it once. There are no overdubs. It is a perfect performance on the first try. This just goes to show how much they had played it up to this point in their lives already. Chord-wise, we have an extremely simple, extremely classic 12-bar blues, just like Boys, Chains, Money, Little Child, You Can't Do That, Can't Buy Me Love, though there is a pretty interesting moment on the second guitar solo as the guitar moves its way up. The chords also move up the neck of the guitar. It's a very cool and climactic moment. Instrumentally, I gotta shout out George Harrison, who plays 2 incredible guitar solos. George Martin, the Beatles producer, is in the studio again playing piano, and Ringo plays an incredible triplet pattern on the last few bars of the song. But Long Tall Sally is all about Paul's vocals. Paul McCartney is screaming for his life like it's nothing. He's doing his best Little Richard impression, and it's not just sort of stacking up. It is just as good as the Little Richard version somehow. This 20-something kid from Liverpool is absolutely annihilating this vocal. And not everybody can do that. I mean, just listen to Pat Boone's version. It's the worst thing ever recorded. Luckily for us, this is not the last time we will hear Paul's incredible screamo voice. We've got She's a Woman, Kansas City, Hey, 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 Helter Skelter, Oh Darlin'. So many songs in this catalog are built around Paul's vocal cords of steel. Speaking of vocal cords of steel, I certainly don't have them, so joining us again to sing this vocal is a friend of the series, Ben Clark. He's one of the only people I know of who could sing this song, and he does it like it's nothing. It's really, really amazing. And also, special guests on this episode, Patrick Heisey's back playing the keys, and Brady Weiss will be playing the incredible guitar part of George Harrison. John Lennon said of Little Richard's Long Tall Sally, "It blew our heads. We never heard anybody sing like that in our lives." I had the same reaction when I heard the Beatles version when I was a kid. So please sit back and enjoy Beatles song number 60, an incredible cover of a legendary tune with great guitar solos and one of the greatest vocals of all time, all done in one take, Little Richard's Long Tall Sally.
I'm going-